Well, we're back on the wonderful River Wye. This time we're fishing the tennis court section in Hereford. It's midwinter and we're going to look at feeder fishing today for chub and barbel. This is my first fish. Probably been fishing for about 45 minutes to an hour. And I'm pretty sure this is a nice barbel. The water's really cold, but the fish still fighting like mad. Right, let's see if we can get him this time. Nice one. What a beautiful, sleek, powerful barbel. It's probably about 5 or 6 pounds. Let's get him in the net. Well, the peg I've selected today is the end peg on the tennis court section. And I spoke to Woody in the local tackle shop and he thought this would be a good area to try. We've had quite a lot of floods recently and the river's been really high for a long time. So we're not exactly sure where the fish shoals are gonna be. But this is nearly always a reliable area, and as that quick barbel's proved, I hope that we can catch some more today. Well, the method I've started with today is a pretty simple block end feeder rig. And I'm fishing a bunch of 3 or 4 maggots on a size 14 hook. And I think this time of year, when the water's cold and the river's up, I mean, there's about 4 or 5 foot of water on today. A maggot feeder like this is a great way to start the session. You're not going to overfeed the peg. And I think it'll give you a good indication as to what's to be caught. Also, because the water's really cold, a static method like fishing a feeder, I think it's going to be your best bet to get a fish to start with. I always like to try and start down the middle in front of me. But quite quickly, it was apparent that there's a lot of snags in that area. In fact, it's quite a snaggy swim. And I think it's all because it's like a slate bed with a channel. And what I'm trying to do is try and find the best area in that channel to fish. So it's a bit of trial and error really to start with, trying to concentrate the feed and the feeder in one area, but moving around dependent on the response from the fish. And also if it's too snaggy to keep fishing in one spot. How long would you give it each spot? think the best advice I was given when I started match fishing on rivers, when feeder fishing, is to think float and fish feeder. And you'll notice that I like to keep casting really regularly. So I'm only actually leaving the feeder in for 4 or 5 minutes. And that achieves a couple of things. It means I'm getting a steady stream of bait flowing through the peg as if I was float fishing. And I'm also learning a lot about the swim and the flow and the area that I'm fishing. So obviously if I started fishing and I was having problems with snags, I'd very quickly move to another area in the swim. But my key objective is to find an area where I know I can leave the feeder and keep casting without snagging up. Then I've got a good chance of concentrating some feed and drawing the fish up to where I'm actually fishing. Another thing to establish quite quickly when you're feeder fishing on a river like this is the weight of feeder that you need to hold it in that spot where you want to keep it. You don't want a feeder that's too heavy so it crashes in and doesn't give a good drop back bite. So you want to get the balance right. So to start with, the other thing I'll do is I'll change the weight and side of the feeder to understand what's working best on the day. You'll also notice that obviously when you're fishing on a powerful river like the Wye, I've got my rod angled high up into the air because I want to keep as much line off the water as possible to reduce the resistance on the line and therefore enable me to fish the most optimum feeder for the conditions. The other thing I'm doing is I'm casting. I've found a good spot now, slightly downstream, and I'm casting and I'm feeling the feeder to hit the bottom, and then I'm feeding a good amount of bow out, maybe 10 or 15 meters of line. And that again helps me to know that the feeder is balanced perfectly in the flow. If I tried to tighten up to it straight away, I'd probably have problems with the feeder not holding. And invariably that means it'll move and then just find a snag. My favorite type of feeder when I'm fishing a block end on a river like the Wye is the Camasan blackcaps. And I typically use them in a medium and a large size. Been fishing with the large one today, obviously because we've been catching some fish. If it was a harder day, I'd probably drop down to this smaller size. You'll notice that I've got some extra weights on the feeders. And that's a really important consideration. I'll carry a variety of different feeders with different weights on, from 1 ounce up to 6 ounces. And add-on leads like these are absolutely invaluable to ensure that you can fish the correct weight of feeder to the depth of the river and the conditions that you're faced with. You'll also notice that I like to modify the feeders and actually, for the most part, like to enlarge the holes so I can get a better flow of water through the holes and disperse the maggots quicker. In some cases, I actually cut a slot like that so I can get a quick explosion of maggots out the feeder almost before it hits the bottom. That can be deadly in the summer when you want to catch fish on the drop. Look at that, I've got a bite while I've been chatting and that fish has hooked itself. It's another barbel. And it's fighting hard in the flow. So when I'm fishing and catching barbel like this, I just like to take it easy to start with. Just gauge the size of the fish and just gradually start to bring it in. So I'm using a 4-pound Trilene XT hook length, which is a strong hook length, but I've still got to take my time with the fish. I think if I was really catching well, and certainly in the summer months, I'd like to step up to a 6-pound hook length. Just gives you a greater margin for error, and especially if you're trying to build a big weight of fish. But I do like to fish a bit finer in the winter. I think it gets you more bites. So you'll notice that I'm not backwinding on the fish at all. I'm just letting the drag of this reel give line when the fish wants to run. And I'm always wary of that bolt that they often do as you start to get the fish up to the net. There we go. Another beautiful Wye barbel. So a lot of the time when I'm feeder fishing on a river like the Wye in the winter when the temperature's dropped, is I like to fish with maggots. I think obviously maggots will catch anything that swims. And one of the problems of using maggots in the warmer months is that you can get pestered with smaller fish. But typically in the winter, the smaller fish aren't feeding. So I'll pretty much always start with maggots in the feeder and maggots on the hook. So this style of feeder fishing on rivers, it's often called fishing with a bow in the line. And as I mentioned, it's very, very effective because you'll notice that when I'm casting and I'm casting out and I'm feeling the feeder onto the river bed, I'm pretty confident that that's pretty much where the feeder's gonna stay. By allowing that big bow of line, it's not pulling the feeder off track. It's quite interesting because actually when you do feel the feeder down onto the bottom, you can learn quite a lot about the river bed. And I can tell straight away here that it's a very hard, like a slate bed. If it was muddy, you wouldn't get such a feeling as the feeder hits the bottom. I'm actually fishing the feeder on a loop, or actually on top of a loop. And I'm going to show you how to tie this rig at the end of the video. But you can see that the feeder is trapped between two gripper stops. And I think the principle of this rig is it's almost like a bolt rig when you're carp fishing. So the feeder's on the bottom, you pay the big bow of line out, and when the fish takes the bait, it pulls it against the stopper, dislodges the feeder, and then actually the fish hooks itself. So varying the hook length can make a big difference. In the summer, you can sometimes go to a really short hook length, maybe 6 or 8 inches if the fish are really feeding well and coming up to the feeder. But typically in the winter when it's colder, I wouldn't use a hook length shorter than about 3 foot, and sometimes go as long as 8 or even 10 foot when the river's low and clear and the fish are actually backing off the feeder. So it's a good trick to think about, is to keep varying the length of your hook length. Well, there we go, that's another fish. And I had actually left that feeder in a bit longer. I'm not sure what it is yet, if it's a chub or a barbel. Thank you. That was a classic drop back bite like we talked about, and the fish had hooked itself. And what I like to do is just be gentle to start with, just get control of the fish and a measure of how big it is. And often on a river, particularly if I'm sitting low to the water like this, I like to stand up and play the fish. There's often lots of ledges and rocks on a river like the Wye, and I want to try and keep the fish up off the bottom as much as possible. And I'm using a 4 pound hook length. So it's a strong, robust hook length, but I've still got to take my time, make sure that I've got a healthy curve in the rod to absorb all the lunges of the fish. And I just like to keep the pressure on and try and move the fish up and towards the netting process. The way it's fighting, I'm pretty sure now it's a barbel. If it's not a barbel, it's a massive chub. Like barbel will often do a quick run, which this one hasn't done yet. Oh no, I pulled out of it, the net. Oh well, there you go. Sometimes happens. There's a barbel about 3 or 4 pound and it just pulled out just as I was lifting it up for the net. Well, with a fish lost like that, there's only one thing to do, and that's change the hook. So while I was waiting for a bite, I've been tying some hook lengths, and I'm gonna put a fresh hook length and hook on. Sometimes when you're fishing on rocky beds like this, the hook can become slightly blunt, and maybe that's all you need to get a poor hook hold in the fish and pull out. So there we go, there's a new hook length, and we'll rebait up with 4 red maggots. The hook I'm using is a size 14 Drennan Super Spade, and I'm using it on a 4 pound Berkeley Trilene XL hook length, which is really strong and robust, something that you definitely got to have when you're barbel fishing on a powerful river like this. I might entertain fishing a high-tech hook length if the river was low and clear, but even then I wouldn't go below 0.20 millimeter. So let's see if we can get out and I can get my own back on the barbel. Right, well I got a bite and I'm into another fish straight away. So I'm not going to say too much this time, I'm going to just try and get him in the net. Well, there you go, I managed to get that one out. Similar size to the first one, about 5 or 6 pounds. And even though it's cold, it really did fight quite hard in that powerful flow. So the rod I'm using today is an Agility 14 foot continental feeder. It's absolutely bang on, I think, when you're fishing on powerful rivers like the Wye. I think the extra 14 foot helps with casting, and it also helps you to keep more line off the water. The tips supplied with it, you get 3 carbon tips. There's a 2 ounce, 3 ounce, and 4 ounce. And I'm using the stiffest 4 ounce tip today. And I think that's a good tip really, because it's gonna register those drop back bites even more. It's gonna exaggerate the drop back bites even more. Well, this is turning into a fun day now. I'm getting a fish almost every cast. I am having to wait 5 or 10 minutes, but it's clear that the fish are feeding. And my teammate Brian Rigby's above me, and I think he's playing one as well. So he's turning it into a bit of a competition. There we go. Another smaller fish, about 3 pounds. But great fun and a great weight builder in a match. A general rule is that you can get the barbel up quite quickly, but they nearly always do a run, especially when it's warmer conditions than this. At the moment, this one's just sort of plodding around under the rod tip, but I'm just wary that it might run off at any second. I don't want to repeat that fish that I lost earlier. Anyway, here we go. A bit smaller, this one. Looks like it's around about 3 pounds. There you go. You can see the bunch of maggots hooked squarely in the scissors. So that fish hooked itself, just like all the other bites I've had, but had a very positive drop back. It's just a case of winding down to the fish. There you go. Still, what a beautiful barbel. Best hook bait today has been a bunch of maggots. So 3 or 4 maggots on a size 14 hook. And I do like red maggots when I'm fishing for chub and barbel on a river. And I'll sometimes try a bronze and a cocktail between the two. You'll notice that I like to hook them alternately, so one through the head and one through the tail, one through the head, one through the tail. And I just think it gives plenty of hook left to actually get a good hook hold and penetration, as opposed to hooking them all through the head in the normal way. So I mentioned in the video that I'm using the new Agility Continental feeder rods today. We do these rods in a 12, 13 and 14 foot length. And they're an extremely versatile rod for long range feeder fishing on still waters, and absolutely perfect for river fishing like today. The reels I'm using today are actually some field test samples. They're called Agility LC 4000 and they're coming out in September. I'm really impressed with them. I think they're a really wonderful reel for feeder fishing. They're very smooth and powerful, and the size of the spool I think really helps with casting. Okay, so let's take a close look at the rig that I'm using today. First thing to mention is the main line. I've set two rods up, one with 8 pound Berkeley XT and one with 6 pound. I think it's such a fantastic, tough, reliable line. I absolutely love it when I'm feeder fishing on rivers. So the rig I've used is a version of the loop bolt rig, but instead of putting the feeder link inside the loop, I actually utilise these Drennan gripper stops, and I'll show you exactly what I mean by creating the rig. So the first thing I do is I attach a gripper stop to the main line, a snap swivel and another gripper stop, and the idea is I push them up out the way, then I make a big loop on the main line. So I use the double figure of eight loop knot. Like that. And then I actually make a loop which the feeder's going to run between. And you can vary that distance. I'm going to go for about 6 ounces on this case, 6 inches rather. And then the loop that's remaining, I'll make 3 or 4 loops in that. And the idea of doing that is it creates a stiff boom that helps to keep the hook length away from the feeder when you're casting and reeling in. And it really is a effective rig, because not only is it very good for hooking the fish, but you get very few tangles with it. So there you go. And what I now do is I pull those gripper stops back over the loop, and I put the bottom one on the bottom loop, slide the swivel over, and then I leave the top gripper stop over that knot. So you can see that I've got a section of line there that the swivel and feeder can run over, but it's trapped between the two to help create the bolt effect. But one negative thing about the loop method, if you put the swivel inside the loop, is if you're playing a fish and the feeder gets stuck at any point, the fish can crack you off against the loop. But with this, it'll pull that gripper stop, and you can see that the feeder can be trapped and then pull away, so you don't lose the fish. And I think that helps me prevent what people sometimes talk about when they say they got cracked off or bitten off when they're playing a hard fighting fish like a chub or a barbel. And also, of course, it makes it a safe rig if you were to crack off, lose the gear, and a fish was to take the bait. So I think that's a really neat rig, and one that's very, very effective. I've actually refined this rig further now, and I like to add a small swivel to the bottom loop. So I just simply push the swivel on, loop it through, and that gives me a great advantage for attaching my hook length. Obviously helps to reduce spin, but more importantly, it helps to prevent the mainline loop from being damaged if I'm constantly changing hook lengths, or if I'm catching a lot of fish on one hook length. So then all I simply do is attach my hook length to that swivel. So there we go. And I do like to use a snap swivel, obviously, because I can change the feeder very, very quickly. Let's get it back out and see if we can catch another barbel. Well, we're coming to the end of the day now, and I think I'm going to make this the last barbel. There you go. Another beautiful wide barbel. I've had such an enjoyable day today fishing the feeder. Well, the weather curtailed the fishing a bit, and we've retreated back to Woody's shop. As you can see from the photo, I've had a cracking day, 6 nice barbel, 2 chub. I hope the tips we've shown you today have helped, and always remember to come and see Woody, and he'll put you right like he did with me today.
Always try our best, mate.
Cheers, Woody.
James.